Hello guys, back again. Time to go back up to the plots and check out the cauliflower harvest down on the little farmer's farm with my brother Velo. Alright, I'll let him check it from here. See you in a bit. Ta-da. So, yeah, our cauliflowers. Said about them yesterday, didn't I? There's some beauties amongst them. I mean, that's a cracker there. They've got some nice ones. Remember, nitrogen-rich soil. These are good ones, aren't they? Now, they've had the nettle tea this year. Put the nettle tea on them. This cover's been off now for over a week. Probably about 10 days this cover's been off. So the cabbage whites have had a go at them. Cabbage white butterflies. But also the Tweety birds will be getting a feed off them when the maggots come out. The maggots, the caterpillars come out. The Tweety birds have been feasting on them. I've seen some this morning having a go at them. And as you can see, there's not a great deal of caterpillar action, to be honest. The ones that are close to the edge here, the slugs and the caterpillars have had a go at, but the majority of it is in decent condition on the leaves. And you can eat the leaves, of course, as well, in the same way you can eat it. We eat it like cabbage. You can have cauliflower leaf, and you can also, any member of the brassica family, you can eat the leaves of. But we're going to go for the heads. There's some nice cauliflowers there. I've just given five away, five full collies. Three to my mum and two to a couple that were passing by. So they've got an allotment down there, but they didn't have any collies this week. Yeah, so as I was saying, there's some decent collies there, varying sizes, but the quality looks good, doesn't it? It's a bit of a comparison with my hand there. So that's as big as my head, that one. That's not far behind. I am a big head though. But there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1 underneath, 9. There's 9 and I've given 5 away, so that's 14. We've still got loads of them left though. Got 2 left in here, either 2 or 3. I think it's 3. I think it's 3 left in here. We've already taken 5 or 6 out of that previously. And I've just taken another, I think, 14 out. And 1 from in here. Yeah, that's a weedy specimen that never made it, and it's blown, see, that one. Gone to seed, blown. All the year round, these ones are, is the variety. So in the next couple of weeks, we'll be taking a few more, as I say, and freezing them up. But we'll be eating like 1 or 2 a week, and then freezing the rest of them up. So we'll probably take and eat this week a couple of those. If you can see them, I don't know if you can see them there. A couple of those, and then part boiling them and freezing them. So they need to be washed first, obviously. I wash them in a sort of saline water, a warm saline water, and give them a good rinse off. Chop them all up into the florets, boil them or steam them if you like, for about 2 or 3 minutes until they're just getting tender but not tender, and then if that makes any sense, and then put them into freezer bags, Ziploc freezer bags. Get as much air out as you can if you like to do that, or just put them into the freezer bags, put them in the freezer, let them freeze, and then you can take them as you need them over the next 4 or 5 months. Really, we were eating them last year, ones that we pulled up sort of late season in September. We were eating them in March last year, so they don't go off in the freezer. Right, catch you in a minute. Nothing goes to waste down here on the little farmer's farm. All the leaves, the good leaf, you can cook up in stews and soups and whatnot. I'll take it as cabbage, do whatever you like with it. Part of the brassica family, you can do that with most brassicas. In fact, not all brassicas you can do that with. But what we're doing with the leaf here is composting it. Now, at the moment, or rather over the next couple of years, you won't be able to buy compost, the sort of clover compost or anything like that, in 2 years' time. So in 2024, there will be no compost of that description, the sort of clover peaty compost. So what we're doing is we're composting everything, all our leaf we're going to compost down. I need to get a couple more bins, actually, because my bins are getting full. So put a load in there, break it all down into sort of 2-inch sections, rots down better that. The worms will be getting into that and eating it. But also, because I've run out of bin space, I'm going to be also putting the chopped leaf and burying it underground. So I'm going to dig out a section of this bed, this deep bed, potato bed, dig out a section of that, bury the leaf underneath the ground, a few inches down, and let the worms come up for that. Yeah, it won't take long to do. It won't take long for that to break down. A couple of months in the ground, get the worms to come up for it, feeds the worms. So that's the plan. Yeah, so I'm just dumping it there. I'll be digging that out and just burying it under. Let the worms do the rest. Crusty. Okay. So the leaf is in. The leaf is full of nitrogen. Of my brassica plants. Very nitrogen rich. So that'll go in there. That'll be good food then for the worms. The worms will then convert that into worm castings or worm poop and wee. And it'll re-nutrify the soil. So all you have to do is, like I say, just bury it. Bury it under the ground. With the earth that you dug out from your trench. And Bob's your uncle. Yeah? We'll be doing that all the way along. As the leaf comes out, as the brassica leaf and whatever you comes out. Even this leaf will do. That can go back in there. All the organic material goes back in there. Because our bins are full. It's going to be doing the composting below ground level. But a bit like vermiculture with the worms, you know. So let's get them covered up. We can move on. Good old brother Beelo there, picking his cauliflowers and composting his leaves. More to come this week. More harvesting. And a few other hopeful hints and tips for you. So yeah, if you like what you see, please comment, like and subscribe if you're not already a subscriber. If you are a subscriber, hit that bell notification button so you don't miss another exciting episode. Take care of yourselves and each other. Guru Mafinda signing out. Have a wonderful week. And whatever you do, keep growing. Keep growing with your heads down. Tatty bye, boys and girls. Have a good one.